हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम गिरिजा एम करमाड़ी, लेक्चरर, गवर्नमेंट पॉलिटेक्निक विजयपुर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कोलेजिएट एंड टेक्निकल एजुकेशन. स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस सेशन वील राइट आर्म प्रोग्राम टू फाइंड स्क्वायर ऑफ ए गिवन नंबर यूजिंग लुकअप टेबल. इन दिस सेशन वील राइट एल्गोरिदम, फ्लो चार्ट एंड देन प्रोग्राम. Then we'll see how we can execute this program on Keel Microvision 4. Finally, we'll see multiple choice questions on this session. Students, before writing the algorithm, first we'll see what actually is this algorithm is. Algorithm is nothing but a step-by-step procedure to write a program. So this algorithm tells the programmers how to code the programs. That means, what are the instructions we can use to write a program? It is observed that what operations are being used. Okay, once we write the steps, okay, so we'll come to know that what are the operations are used in the program. Okay, so next we'll write the algorithm. Okay, so the ARM programs are always started with defining the areas. Okay, so first we'll define the code area, then start the program. The ARM programs are started with the assembler directive entry, then assign the starting address of a lookup table to the register R0. You can use any general purpose registers. Here I have used R0, and then load a number whose square to be determined into the register R1. Okay, again I can use any general purpose registers. I have used here R1. Then generate the corresponding address of a square number. Then load the square number to the register into the register R2. Then create the lookup table with the name table. Okay, so the name of the lookup table can be a user choice. Here I have taken it as a table. Once we get the output, end the program using the assembler directive end. Okay, now we have written the algorithm. So now next step is draw the flow chart. Okay, so before drawing the flow chart, we'll see what is a flow chart. A flowchart is a graphical representation of an algorithm, that is a step-by-step approach to solve a task. Here the task is what? Writing a program. Okay. This flowchart shows the steps as a boxes of various kinds and their order by connecting the boxes with arrows. Okay. So in the algorithm, we have written the steps. So in the flowchart, those steps are represented with the various boxes. Okay, and those boxes are connected by arrows. Okay, that is what is a graphical representation. Okay, so this is a flowchart. Okay, so idu enidu flowchart. Okay, so already now nodidivi flowchart antre enu ondu graphical representation, pictorial representation. Okay, so now program hing yav tara start madbeku, enenu now input tagobeku, enu output namage barutte, amale enenu in between input tagondo matte enge process martivi. Okay, adinella nav en martivi idralli ಬಾಕ್ಸಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದನ್ನ ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಮತ್ತು ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸಸ್ನೇ ಬೇರೆ ಥರ ಬಾಕ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ರೀಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇದು ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಫ್ಲೋ ಚಾರ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಚಾರ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್, ದೆನ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದಿ ರಿಜಿಸ್ಟರ್ R1, ದೆನ್ ಅಸೈನ್ ದಿ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಅಡ್ರೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಲುಕ್ಅಪ್ ಟೇಬಲ್ ಟು ದಿ R0. Okay, then calculate the corresponding address of a squared number. Once we get the squared number, store that output into the register R2, initialize the lookup table, then end the program. Okay, this is a flow chart. We have written the algorithm, then we have drawn the flow chart. Okay, so next step is what? we have to write the program. Okay, so what is our program? We have to find the square of a given number between 1 to 10 using lookup table. Okay, so what actually is this lookup table is? A lookup table, it is an array that replaces runtime computation with a simpler array indexing operation. That means this lookup table is nothing but an array. So array, it can be a single dimensional or multi-dimensional array. Okay, so these tables may be pre-calculated and stored in a program storage. Okay, the values which are stored in this lookup table, they are already pre-calculated and they are stored in the ROM memory. Okay, these lookup tables of values are used to speed up the hand calculations of complex functions. Okay, so example, logarithmic table. Okay, where the table contains the values of the logarithmic values for the given number. Okay, so these lookup tables are used to speed up the hand calculations. Okay, students, ಇದು ನಮ್ಮದು ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮು. ನಮ್ಮದು ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಏನು, ನಾವು ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಒಂದರಿಂದ ಮತ್ತು ಹತ್ತರ ಒಳಗಡೆದು. ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ನಂಬರ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟರು ಅದರದ್ದು ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆ, ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಲುಕಪ್ ಟೇಬಲ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನಾವು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಲುಕಪ್ ಟೇಬಲ್ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನಾವು to find this one, we have to define the lookup table. Okay, as I told you, we have to give a name for the lookup table. Okay, a label must be given. Okay, so here we have declared a lookup table and the name of the lookup table is table. Okay, as I said, it is a user choice. Okay, so this DCB is a one of the assembler directive. What it will do, it will assign a constant byte. Okay, so here we have assigned here 10 bytes here. Since we have to find squares of any 10 numbers here between 1 to 10, so we have here declared the lookup table, and in this, these are the squares of numbers from 1 to 10. Okay, so square of 1 is 1, square of 2 is 4, square of 3 is 9, so on up to 10. Okay, so using this lookup table, we have to find the square for a given number. Okay, so let's see how we can find this one. So as I told you, the ARM programs are started with the defining the area. Okay, so define the area, we have to give the name for the area. Again, it is a user choice. Here I have given the name of the area as a square. This is a code area, and then the instructions are read only. Now begin the program. So the ARM instructions are started with the assembler directive entry. So this entry indicates this is the beginning of the program. Okay, so now assign this R0 with the initial address of the lookup table. Our name of the lookup table is table, so the starting address of the lookup table is assigned into the register R0. Then assign the value or number whose square is to be determined into the register R1. Okay, now then next we have to find out the address of a squared number. Okay, how to generate this one? Here subtract R1 with immediate value or constant value 1. Okay, so what is R1? R1 is loaded with 3. Okay, so 3 minus 1. Okay, so which is equal to 2. Okay, so now R1 is loaded with the value 2. Okay, then again what we are doing, we are adding the value R1, value in the R1 with the content in the R0, and they are stored, the result value is stored back into the R0. Okay, so what we are doing is R0 is containing the initial address of the lookup table. Okay, suppose if you consider, for example, the address is 40, initial address is 40. So 40 is added with the content R1, content R1 is 2. So this will become 40 plus 2 will become 42, and it is stored back into the register R0, so that is 42. Okay, so in the next, what we are doing, so this square inside the R0 indicates that R0 is containing a memory address. In that memory address, whatever the value is there, that will be loaded into the register R2. Here we are only copying a 1 byte of memory, that is LDRB indicates 1 byte of value from this memory is copied into the R2. Okay, so in the R0, 42 is there as per our example. Okay, so whatever there in the 42, that will be copied into the R2. Okay, so if you consider 40 initial address, 41, then 42. So in the 42, what is there? Value 9 is there. 9 will be copied into the register R2. Okay, so once we get the output, then end the program using the assembly directive END. Okay, students, artha aitala idu namdu program ARM program yavade square number 1 rinda 10 olagade yavade square number na find out madlikke idu namdu ondu program. Okay, so iga algorithm baridvi, flow chart draw madidvi, ಮತ್ತೆ ಆರ್ಮ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ನ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ನಾವೀಗ ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಈ ಸೇಮ್ ಬರೆದಿರೋ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ನ ಕೀಲ್ ಮೈಕ್ರೋವಿಷನ್ 4ನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಇವಾಗ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಸಿ ಹೌ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಆನ್ ಕೀಲ್ ಮೈಕ್ರೋವಿಷನ್ 4. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಓಪನ್ ದಿ ಕೀಲ್ ಮೈಕ್ರೋವಿಷನ್ 4. Okay students, so in the previous session we already seen how to create a new project and how we can write the program and how to execute the ARM program. Okay, let's once again we will see today how to execute a program on the Keil Microvision 4. Okay, with a given program. So for this one, go to new project. First you have to create the new project. Okay, so you have to create this new project, okay, in a new folder. So for that you have to take any drive. Okay, prefer any drive other than C drive. So I will prefer D drive. Then in the D drive, create a new folder. Okay, so name of the folder I have given ARM program, it is user choice. So open this one. Then in this folder, create a file without any extension, then save this one. When you save this one, you are redirected to a dialog where you are asked to choose a device from this device database. Okay, we are writing ARM program for the LPC 2148 from the NXP manufacturer. So select NXP, under this one select LPC 2148, say OK. It will ask whether to add the startup code, say no. So now we have created the project. Next we have to create the file. Okay, take a new file from the file menu. Okay, so now in this file we have to write the program. Okay students, just to save our time, I have taken already whatever is there in the previous slide, I have copied the same program. Okay, now save this one. To save this, control S, and this will be stored in the folder just now what we have created. So the file name can be user choice, since I have written here square, so I'll give the name of the file as square, and the extension must be .asm, since it's a assembly program. So always for the assembly programs, the files are stored with the file name followed by .asm. Okay, save this one. So when you save this one, this is okay. To build it, we have to add this file into the project. Okay, to do so, right click on the source group, add files to group. Okay, then choose the .asm. So this is our file. Then say add. Okay, then close. Here we can see here the file is added. Okay, once the file is added, you can now you have to build it. To build it, either you can go for this build target or the shortcut is F7. Okay, so the one more shortcut is here. Okay, see here students, we have got some error here. Okay, so to check the errors and to check the location of the error, just to double click on this one. Okay, so it is showing error is there on the first line. Okay, so one thing we have to remember that this ARM programs requires alignment. Okay, that means the areas are must be defined with one or two tab space from the left margin. Okay, so now we have corrected this one. So when we change this one, again we have to build it. Okay, so again go to this one, build. Okay, so when we build this one, there are no errors. Okay, so zero errors and zero warnings. Okay, now next step is what? We have to run the program. To run this one, go to debug, or we have a shortcut here, start and stop debug session. Okay, now okay, it's a just a information message, evaluation mode. Okay, say okay. Now our program is ready to run. Okay, so you can see here many windows. In the previous session we have seen what are all these windows. Okay, this is a disassembled file, and this is our program file, and this is a project manager where we can see the project list as well as the register contents, and this is our output window. Okay, so as we know, we can execute this either with the run or with the step 11. Step 11 will show each step by step execution. Okay, let's go for the F11. Okay, so now see, whatever the initial address of the table, okay, that is loaded into the register R0. Okay, so R0 is containing the address, initial address. Okay, then so R1 is loaded with the value 3. Okay, then R1 is subtracted with 1, so 3 minus 1 is what? 2. So the new content of the R1 is 2. Okay, then add content of R0 and R1. So R18 plus 2, okay, which is nothing but 1A. Okay, so now in this instruction what will happen? See here, R0, R2 is 0 here. Okay, so after this instruction, now the value is what? 9. So that means whatever is there in the address 1A, that is loaded into the R2, okay, which is nothing but a square of number 3. Okay, so we have got this output in the register R2. Okay, so once we get the output, okay, we have to stop the program. Okay, to stop this one, again go to start and stop debug session. Okay students, okay, this is how we can execute this program on the Keil Microvision 4. Okay, so let's go back to the session. Students, we have written algorithm, flowchart, and then we have written the program, and also we have executed and we got the output. Okay, so let's see some multiple choice questions on this session. Okay, so first question, function of LDRB instruction is, okay, what is the function of LDRB? Okay, so you should know this one because we have used this instruction in our program. Okay, so the options are load byte into a register, load word into a register, load half word into a register, none of the above. So the answer is A. Okay, it will load byte into a register. Okay, so what is the file extension that is loaded in a microcontroller for executing any instruction? So the options are .hex, .c, .txt.asm. Okay, so with what file extension the files are saved here? Okay, so the answer is d.asm. Okay, next, the main importance of ARM microprocessor is providing operation with, okay, so low cost, low power consumption, high degree of multitasking, low error or glitches, efficient memory management. Okay, the main importance of ARM microprocessor is what? Low cost and low power consumption. Okay, so the answer is option A. Next, what is the processor used by ARM 7? Okay, which processor is used in the ARM 7? So the answer is D, that is it uses 32-bit RISC processor. So the abbreviations for CISC and RISC are, okay, what are the long form of CISC and RISC? So the option is, right option is B. Okay, CISC stands for complex instruction set computer, RISC stands for reduced instruction set computer. Okay, so the next question, register contains options address, next option data, next option both, or none of the above. Okay, the ARM, the register contains both, that is answer, the option is C. The register contains both address as well as data. The directive that marks the end of an assembly language program is, okay, the options are ends, end, stop, none of the mention. Okay, which directive is used to mark the end of the assembly program? Okay, so we have used this assembly directive. Okay, so the option is B, end is a right option. The logic required for implementing a program can be expressed in terms of flowchart, algorithm. See both flowchart and algorithm, none of them mentioned. Okay, so the right option is C, both flowchart and algorithm are used, okay, to express this program logic. Okay, next, the dash directive specifies the start of the execution. Okay, so the options are start, entry, main, origin. Okay, which directive is used to begin the program? Okay, the option is entry. Okay, this entry indicates the beginning of the program. So the last question, execution of ARM assembly programs requires alignment. Okay, so whether the statement is true or false. Okay, students, we have seen while executing the program, okay, we missed the alignment, so we got the error. So that means this ARM instruction requires the alignment. So the answer is option A, that is true. Okay, students, so these are the references we referred to develop this content. This is our whole team which we worked together to build this content. Thank you, students.